Good afternoon, the respected chairperson, all the jury members, and the listeners. My name is Ragini Eknath Gharat, student of Government Institute of Forensic Science, Nagpur. The topic of my presentation is DNA Technology Regulation Bill 2019 in India. Dr. Harshvardhan, who is the Union Minister of Science and Technology, introduced this DNA Technology Regulation Bill 2019 in the Lok Sabha. This bill is also called as DNA Profiling Bill. The purpose of this bill is to expanding the application of DNA-based forensic technologies to support the justice system of our country. The main aim of this bill is to regulate the use and application of DNA technology for the purpose of establishing the identity of certain category of person, including victims, offenders, suspects, under trials, missing person, and unknown deceased person. Andhra Pradesh is the first state who used the DNA profiling for the investigation. This bill is lapsed in Rajya Sabha when it passed from the Lok Sabha due to the lack of support of opposition. Going to the next slide for the provision of the bill. Okay. It seeks to establish the national data bank and regional data bank. Every data bank will maintain the indices like crime scene index, suspects or under trial index, offender index, missing person index, and unknown deceased person index. It also seeks to regulate the DNA testing and analysis by providing further accreditation. Establishment of national and regional DNA data bank to store and maintain the DNA profile and DNA regulatory board for their governance. It also ensured that DNA must be protected from the misuse or abuse in terms of privacy right of our citizen. This bill also proposes written consent is required to obtain before the collection of DNA sample from the individual. But the consent is not required in such cases for the offenses with punishable for the more than 7 years in jail or death penalty. It also provides for the removal of DNA profiles for of suspects and under trials on the basis of court order. Profiling crime scene and missing person index will be removed on a written request. There are pros and cons also there regarding to this bill. Pros: the DNA test can be easily used to identify criminals and also establish a relationship between a person with one to another. The arrested person cannot be forced against their will to provide a DNA sample, but there are some exceptions also. Data will be accepted from the investigator and the match with the data available in the data bank. DNA pattern will kept in the DNA bank and will be used whenever it is required for the purpose of a nation interest, police interest, and the forensic interest. DNA pattern will kept under the government regulatory body, so there is a very least chances of their misuse. There are cons also there, due to which there is a lack of support and it not passes through the Rajya Sabha. Many claims that the DNA profiling bill is a violation of human rights and it compromises the privacy of individual because it contains the details of person's body and the DNA profile, and it is stored in the DNA data bank. It is not used for only the settlement of criminal cases, but also the civil matter also in case of DNA profiling. Such as surrogacy, paternity and maternity check, organ transplantation, and immigration also. One important point is there, large scale of technological system in India, proposed DNA database bank, DNA database project has to suffer from the lack of cost analysis study. Ma'am, next slide, please. What about the other countries? There are 60 countries where the DNA technology is used for the investigate the crime, which includes United States, China, Canada, Argentina, but there are Another, some countries where the DNA profiling is allowed only in the serial criminal cases, such as Germany, France, Netherlands, and this provision is existed in India also. By taking prior permission from the court, biological sample of suspect in criminal cases are taken and the DNA profiling is done. Before going to conclusion, I wanted to share one case study with you. This case study is belong to the Kurla area, Mumbai. The serial rapist Rehan Qureshi, who is 34 years old, on February 2010, a 6-year-old girl was sexually abused before being killed, and her dead body was found on the stair of nearby building. Within 1 month, on March 2010, a 9-year-old girl was raped and murdered, and her body was found on the terrace of police quarter of Nehru Nagar police station. The Nehru Nagar police station already investigating the case, which was happened on February 2010. The modus operandi of both the cases is similar. In this case, the DNA test was conducted by the police of all who had proximity to the victim, including family members, friends, and those who come in the society daily for their work. There are 800 plus tests are carried out, and there is a formation of database for this case. And the rapist Rehan Qureshi was arrested by the Mumbai crime branch after 8 years on September 2018. His DNA was matched with the sample which is collected from the from these two victims in Nehru Nagar. This was the first case in India where the pending rape and murder case was solved with the help of DNA database of criminals created by the government. Conclusion. According to the data by Directorate of Forensic Science Services, there are 12,000 plus forensic DNA sample, which may be the crucial evidence in some cases of rape and murder, are still lying unexamined in the Central Forensic Science Laboratory due to the storage of well-equipped DNA labs and the data. There is also a reason because time-consuming DNA analysis without any pre-record of DNA. This bill will help in solving criminal as well as civil cases by keeping the privacy of person protected, and it contribute in the step of development of nation. Thank you, ma'am.